5 seconds. I have great pleasure today to be with you all this morning. When we met last year, I recall there was to some extent some plain speaking on my part. At the outset, I would like to make it clear once again that today also I would to do the same thing. In the years that followed our independence, thanks to the determination and great efforts, our great leaders, the country witnessed all-round development. That is the reason why we are able to communicate with each other so easily today. The large projects, iron and steel factories, development in science and technology have changed our economy to a very great extent. On account of the various facilities provided and subsidies given, many large-scale industries have come up and small-scale industries too followed them. With the great efforts of our small farmers, we have achieved self-sufficiency in the field of food. Today, we are in a position to export some quantities of food grains to friendly countries which may be in need. The private sector has played an important role in industrial growth since independence. It was helped in increasing national wealth and have provided employment to large numbers. Several industrial units have set up high standards of efficiency, quality production, and have also managed their organizations efficiently with a great deal of skill. Their products are welcomed in various countries of the world in spite of severe competition. The public sector also grew in size and content over the years. The important projects were by and large in the public sector, and while some units lagged behind, I am glad to note that during the last few years, there has been a great development in the performance of public sector undertakings. I would also like to congratulate the managers of the concerned public sector undertakings on this performance. I am quite confident that a climate of growth would be created in the country with the combined efforts of the public and private sectors. I would like to emphasize the need for a healthy competition between the public and private sectors, which would be beneficial for efficient functioning of both. Economic growth has to go side by side with social injustice. As I have often said, concentration of wealth in a few hands will not be good for the country. Dear sir, I am in receipt of your letter dated 10th November and noted the contents of it. I am very glad to know that you are sending a delegation to our company to have a first-hand information about the activities being carried out by us. It is great pleasure for us to receive the delegation. We have already made arrangements like providing transport accommodation for the visiting delegation and PowerPoint presentation to be made by our dedicated officers. I hope and trust that the team to be visited will be benefited in all aspects during their visit and stay at our company premises. I request you to kindly intimate well in advance the number of delegates and their tour particulars so as to enable us to make suitable arrangements for them. If time permits, we will also arrange pleasure trips to various tourist important places in and around Hyderabad city after official visit.